Hi there, and welcome back to another video of our Selenium C# with MSTest framework in our LambdaTest platform series. And in this video, we're going to talk about how we can run a parallel cross-browser testing with Selenium C# and MSTest framework. In our last video, we discussed how we can write a simple code with Selenium C# with MSTest framework, something like this. And we didn't really saw how we can actually leverage the power of parallel execution or running the cross-browser testing with MSTest framework. And in this video, we are going to see how we can do all of them using Selenium C# Selenium Grid setup. So in order to achieve the parallel testing as well as the cross-browser testing, we are going to create a new class file in our project. And we're going to call this as WebDriver init. And within this class file, we are going to perform like a driver initialization and like a browser option initialization as well as an enum, which is going to be looking something like this. So this is the enum, the browser type enum that we are going to be using this time to set the browser type for us. And then we are going to be creating the browser option method, which is going to look something like this. So within this browser option, you can see that we have used the browser type as a parameter, and also we did a switch case to get the browser options such as Chromium options or Firefox option or Edge options or Safari options over here. So we need to add the reference for all of them because Visual Studio is complaining us that these references are not there in this particular class file. So we need to add them all, and you can see that this is the get browser option. So this browser option method is going to basically return as the browser option that we are looking for within our method that we are going to be writing over here. So we are going to write a method, something like public iWebDriver. So let me add this reference, and then we're going to call this as get WebDriver. So this get WebDriver method is also going to accept the browser type as a parameter. And then it is going to expect us to have the capabilities, which is then being required for our remote web driver of Selenium. So we need to set the capabilities over here using this get browser options that we have just created over here. So now that we have this particular capability, and now we need to call our remote web driver to hook with our Selenium Grid setup. I already have the Selenium Grid setup over here. It's already running the server, and it's also running two nodes for us, which has these capabilities as you can see over here. It has one node with Internet Explorer, Firefox, and Chrome browser running, and another node which has Firefox IE, Edge browser, as well as the Chrome browser. So it has other capabilities in this. And because we have the limitation that this is an Windows operating system and I can't really run the Safari browser in it, and also I cannot run multiple versions of browsers in my machine. If I need to, then probably I need to run a different node in a different machine which has a different versions of browsers in it. But at the moment, within my machine, those are limitations and I can't really do that. Well, you got the point right now that this is the setup that I have got in my Selenium Grid setup. And I can use this capabilities to run my cross-browser testing. Also, we can perform the parallel browser testing. So now we have everything, and now we need to write a bit of code to connect with the remote web driver, and the code is going to look something like this. And as usual, this is a normal Selenium Grid setup where we have a remote web driver and we have passed the new URI of the local Selenium Grid. And we have passed the capability that we have obtained from the get browser options method. And again, it's going to return us a dynamic browser options, so we can keep extending regardless of its type. So it's all sitting in over here. And then we are going to be using the same lambdatest.github.io sample to do app that we used in our earlier video of this series. As you can see that this is the simple setup that we have for the get web driver. And because we already have the web driver option, which has the capabilities being set and everything, we don't necessarily require this test initialized to do it for us. Rather, we can do it from the easiest way within our code using the using keyword of C#, where we can create a disposable object in the using keyword. So I'm just going to type this get web driver, And you can see that we get this particular error because this web driver doesn't really exist. The reason being, this particular web driver, get web driver method, is actually sitting in the web driver init class. So we need to inherit the web driver init class so that we get this get web driver over here. And now that we get this get web driver, but we need to pass the browser type here. We can do it in two ways. Either we can just hard code the browser type, something like Chrome, like this, and we can probably close the parentheses over here, and it looks okay. But if we want to use different browsers like Firefox browser, then I need to either create a separate method to do that, something like this, and we can call this as test method too, and here we can call this as Firefox, or we can also use the data-driven way of MSTest framework to leverage that for us. So let's try to run a simple code just with this setup, like the Chrome and with the Firefox, using two different methods, and then we'll see how we can run them using a data-driven setup method. So we are gonna choose these two test methods, and then we are gonna be executing them right now, and they are gonna be running the test in sequential mode this time. And as you can see, it has opened the Chrome browser, and it has just got failed, which is all right. And then it has opened the Firefox browser, and it's running the test, and it's gonna fail as well. The reason it's failing is because it doesn't really have this driver.quit method, because we don't really have a driver initialization happening at the moment. So this particular driver variable is kind of obsolete, and we don't really require that within our test method itself. And since this driver is being disposed within this particular using block itself, we can do the driver.quit over here itself. So which will actually quit the driver or nothing but the browser for us. And then the test will automatically pass if we do this. And we can remove this test cleanup as well. So now that you can see that we have made our code even more super simplified, and if we try to run these tests, it will run fine without any problem. But now the next question comes is how that we can actually run the same test using the data-driven way so that we can control all the browsers in one single place instead of creating two different methods. And that's the reason we are going to be using their data-driven approach of MSTest using the data row attribute. So this data row attribute can actually get any number of parameters which we can pass in, something like browser type dot Chrome. And similarly, I can create something like data row browser type dot Edge, something like this. So once these changes are made, we also need to change the browser type that we have hard-coded here on the get web driver. And this one we can do using this browser type being as a parameter within this test method, and we can use this browser type as a parameter for the get web driver method. So this way, it is going to be much, much easier to handle the two browser running for us over here instead of just one browser. So let's try to run the same code right now using a data-driven testing instead of the hard-coded browser type that we did. And once we run this test of the test method one, it is going to launch the two browser, like the Edge Chrome browser and the Chrome browser for us, and completes the test execution for us. So this way, we could see that it is launching the two browser for us over here. The last quest is to run the test not only just in cross-browser testing, but also in parallel execution testing. And this parallel execution in MSTest is also much, much easier to be done, which is pretty much like the Selenium way of doing it. Again, we discussed about n-unit parallel execution in our Lambda test series, as well as in spec flow series, we discussed about how we can run the parallel execution. That's exactly the same idea being used in the MSTest framework as well. All we need to do is we need to call the assembly over here, and then we're gonna call this parallelize attribute where we can actually pass the workers here. So in this MSTest framework, there is something called as workers, which actually helps you to set number of workers that you need to be calling to run your codes in parallel execution. You can set the workers as 0 or 1, like depends on how many instances that you want to execute. And then you can set the scope to the execution scope of the levels in the method level or in the class level. And because we only have one class and we have multiple methods, we can use this method level, which can do that trick for us. So this way, this particular code is actually going to be executing in parallel execution this time. And now while we try to run this test, you could see that both these tests are now running in parallel for us, and they have completed execution pretty much on the same time. So now that you can see that the total duration of the execution was 30 seconds while we set the worker threads to 0, but if we try increasing the worker threads to 1, you could see that our test execution is going to be a bit faster than it is actually, because it is going to spawn a number of threads for us, and the execution is going to be actually faster than its usual time frame. So you could see that the total time for this particular test is actually 21 seconds of duration instead of 30 seconds of duration. So the number of workers that we increase, it is going to increase the speed of our test execution. So this is the way that we could actually run the parallel execution in MSTest framework using Selenium C#. But in our next video, we'll discuss how we can leverage the power of LambdaTest platform to perform the same parallel execution operation, but not limiting to just one browser versions or one platform like an operating system, rather using multiple different operating systems, multiple different browsers, and multiple different browser versions, which we'll be discussing in our next video.
As always, please post any questions in the comments below or at community.lambdatest.com. See you in the next video.